Hi,
we are
Humberto Martinez
and Ian Mariscal,
and we are going to talk about
the story of
Hiroshima Mon Amour.
Hiroshima Mon Amour is a 1959 French-Japanese film directed by Alain Resnais and the film script written by Marguerite Duras, starring Emmanuel Riva, Eiji Okada, and Bernard Fersen in the lead roles. It deals with an intense personal conversation between a French-Japanese couple about the memory and forgetting. The story starts when a young French actress, after shooting a movie in Hiroshima about peace, spends her last night in a hotel, in the company of a Japanese man. Both of them are two strangers, but what could be a fleeting one-night stand turns into an intense idyll that makes her recall an impossible love living in the Vers, France a few years before.
The Japanese man lost his entire family in the bombing of Hiroshima. Losing his family in such a tragic way came to cause him a great trauma. War only causes pain and suffering. However, 14 years after the bombing, the Japanese man is hopeful of a better future, but he will never forget his pain. If we were in the Japanese man's shoes, how should we behave after experiencing a great trauma? Would it be real to act in such a positive way after losing someone in such a devastating way as the Japanese man did? It all depends on forgiveness, and the Japanese man's definitive commitment was to be able to forgive the enemy. But who deserves to be forgiven? A person only deserves to forgiveness if he becomes to acknowledge his mistake. Repentance can heal wounds, but if he never repents, forgiveness will never come. Unfortunately, the man who dropped the atomic bomb on Hiroshima, Paul Tibbets, never felt any remorse for his actions, so it will never be possible for the Japanese man to forget, and in the end, his pain will continue to grow over time, even if he tries to hide it. It's because of this that the Japanese man always said to the French woman, "You don't know nothing," because she really doesn't understand his real pain.
The French woman had fallen in love with a German soldier, who was her first love. Given the context about the Second World War, being a German made you the enemy of any country that was not one of the Axis powers. Therefore, this German soldier was assassinated. Then, the French woman goes crazy for the lust of her lover, and based on this, she's locked up because of the people of her town saw her as a disgrace for having a love with a German soldier. In the same way, she was punished by being locked up underground. In addition to all of this punishment, they shaved her hair. Because of this, she became more and more crazy. Over the years, she recovers her sanity, but she can't forget what happened with the German soldier. If we were in the French woman's feet, would we have suffered the same trauma just like her? Would we have held on to the past just like her? When we hold on to something, we think that our lives has meaning, thanks to what we are holding on to, and that if we ever lost it, life would stop being pleasant. We would lose our direction and illusions. Holding on to something or someone causes a lot of pain, as well as anguish and concern. If we become obsessed people, we will always be anxious due to the possibility of losing what we work so hard to achieve, and that we believe gives meaning to our existence. The French woman's defining commitment was the German soldier, as she simply could not forget everything that had happened with him. This is why she tries to hide how she really feels. In the same way, she tries to appropriate the catastrophe in Hiroshima as if she had been there. Her trauma is also linked to the war on the part of her lover, and all the madness that took over her because of what happened. but she did not leave the war as the Japanese man did.
At the end of the film, there is a great revelation. Throughout the film, we don't know the names of the Japanese man and French woman, but in the last scene, the French woman named the Japanese man Hiroshima, and the Japanese man named her Nevers. This means, after all, that both lovers are the reflection of the pain that was caused by the war to these two cities, which were Hiroshima and Nevers. This makes you wonder, if Hiroshima Mon Amour is a story of two lovers, or is the story of two places where a tragedy has occurred, one massive and the other private. With this, the defining commitment between the French woman and the Japanese man is to reflect the suffering of the population of these two cities, and how they experience pain and hopelessness. But at the end, both cities want to overcome the past and create a better future by learning from their memory. This film is not a fiction. It could be a documentary of the life of millions of people who experienced war and how they're challenged to deal with pain, remember the past, and hope for a better future.